What is up, everybody? It's your boy Slim, aka Mitch Different, back with another video. Today, we are going to be looking at how to use the epic. I'm going to be teaching you how to use. I'm teaching you guys how to make this epic chill pad that I made in Serum pretty easily. So let's go over it, make sure everything's correct. Yes, okay. This is what it sounds like. Oh, too low. We'll just bring down the resonance. I had the resonance too high. My bad. Pretty cool, epic chill pad sound that you can make right in Serum. Really easy, really quick. So let's just go over it. Once again, I'm going to be showing you guys each individual part, step by step. I'm not going to be recreating it from scratch because I want you to get the exact sound I just made. So that's how I work. So with that being said, let's get to it. So let's start off with part A. Part A is just going to be in the vocally sound, which I said you can get these from, I think you can get these from Expert website. Like when you actually pay for Serum, you get all these wave tables. And if you buy it off of, Splice, I think they also give you all these wave tables as well. And also I have the massive ones too, so that's extra. You got to find them, you know, you can get them easy, or you can just import them yourself. That's the easiest way to do it. So yeah, so definitely get that. So I'm using this one called Vocal, and it's called Allophones. And it's kind of a weird looking shape, but it's, if you see, it's pretty cool looking, but it's actually kind of weird. I like the way it looks, like a little mountain ridge. But yeah, I got the wave position table to wave table position to 41. The unisons are all the way up because it's a pad sound, so we want a lot of unisons. And we're going to detune them quite a bit, so about 0.08 is going to be on the detune. And I'm going to add this ASMY function to it, minus. And that's what that's going to do, is kind of push it to one side and other. I think positive will go this way and minus goes this way. And you have plus minus, which kind of goes either or. So it don't really matter which one you use. You can use AMS plus minus or minus and just kind of push it over that way. So, but we use minus just to be, so you can see. So it's pretty cool. So you can definitely do that. So just boink, push it all the way over. Next, we're going to go to oscillator B. Unison's all the way up. We're going to go back to vocally, and we're going to use the ML Adafunk sound. It's another weird-looking table that I really like looking. It just looks cool and looks more talky-y. Definitely called vocally sounds. It's kind of mimicking the human voice somewhat. We're going to have to detune about 15, so we got just a little bit more detune in the first one. The ASYM, again, a YM function minus, and we got to about 75%, so it's not all the way over there, but it's sort of pushing it, but not all the way. Just sort of, kind of, maybe. And then that's about it for the actual wave tables and the oscillators. So we're not worried about those no more. Next, we're going to move over to this filter section. We're using one envelope. That's pretty cool. Could have used envelope one, envelope three. So we're using, go to the filter section. We're going to use the low pass 12 and the multi, not the normal one. We're using the actual one in multi. So LP12, which is low pass 12. And also has like some peaks in it for resonance. So bring the resonance up to about 15%. The cutoff is going to be a 2K. And then the frequency, we're going to put an LFO, just a regular LFO on the frequency. And the frequency is at 32%. And the modulation is at about 20, as you see in the matrix. So filter velocity is at 20. So that's just going to give us a kind of movement between these shapes. See how that one peak right there is moving back and forth if I bring the resonance up. That's for giving that kind of talky sound, but we don't want too much resonance. You can make more resonance. You get more of a vowely talky sound. You hear that wong, 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 wong. You get that kind of wobble sound. But it's up to you to taste. I'm just showing you what I'm doing, and you do it the way you feel is necessary. Envelope one, make a kind of a pad envelope. As you see, it's kind of sloping up slowly and then gently with some release. And here's the exact numbers. 250 milliseconds, 205 milliseconds on release and attack. 1 millisecond on the decay, and that's about it for everything else. And that just gives you, you know, the kind of a pad sound, how it rises up and then gently slopes off. That's just a typical pad sound. Go to the effects. I'm using Hyper Dimension. I only have Dimension on, as always. I mean, Hyper, I don't really use Dimension that much. Dimension is kind of cool, but not in this case. You got to be careful with it. It's in the stock settings. Add some reverb, of course, because reverb just sounds good on a pad sound. Everybody knows that. with a little bit of low cut, a little bit of high cut, and bring down the mix down as always, and a little bit of the size down as well, because sometimes this reverb does sound a little too big and it is on the hall setting. And then we just go to the actual filter, add in the filter, just a regular filter, put on that cool crazy comb filter, and the cutoff is at 900 hertz, and everything else is regular, and the mix is at 37%. So we get, if without it, it sounds like this. Isn't bad, just a typical pad, but with that comb filter, has a little bit more in the higher registers and stuff of that nature. So that's pretty cool and pretty unique in itself. And that's pretty much it. After you do that, you have a cool, crazy, kind of chill pad, kind of in the sense of a Drake Weekend-ish type of sound. So it's pretty unique. And I said, you can cut some more highs of it if you want to. You can add in an extra filter, use like a high cut filter and cut some of the highs out. That way, you know, you can have it a little bit more darker sounding if you so please. But, you know, with that, it has a little bit more in the higher frequencies. So it's pretty cool sound, pretty unique, pretty not, I wouldn't say generic, but it's there with it. But it sounds really good and you can do a lot with it. So, yeah, that's that. So, yeah, there you go. A simple little epic kind of chill pad sound in Serum once again with your boy Slim, aka Mr. Dip. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'm going to keep making these videos, try to get more Serum tutorials out there. I know I've been doing a lot of sign-up stuff, but, you know, I still want to do the sign-up stuff because, you know, sign-up is still dope as always, and I can do some crazy sounds with that as well. So hope you guys enjoyed this, and, you know, you will just constantly keep coming back. Thumb it up. Let me know you didn't like it. You know, check me out, Mr. Different TV, YouTube.com, and everywhere else. With that being said, I hope you guys enjoy it, and I will see you guys next time. Have a good one.